First on Focus at 4, though, sneezing and sniffling, coughing, wheezing. Those are the sounds these days heard in schools and offices and especially in daycares. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention just confirmed Alabama's first cases of enterovirus D68, this so-called mystery virus that is hitting young children especially hard. Focus at 4's Edward Birch joins us right now. Except for this rhinovirus, though, we really haven't heard a whole lot, at least to date, about the flu season. Where do we stand with all
this? Well, it still is early, and actually the Jefferson County Department of Health has no confirmed cases of the flu, and that may be a good thing since it is still pretty early. But sure. Local physicians know that that's going to change in the coming months, and they're encouraging people to get vaccinated now.
Everyone should be vaccinated.
Colleen Donohue, a physician with Brookwood Medical Center, says her office just received shipments of this year's flu vaccine.
We do have certain populations that we push more eagerly to be vaccinated, and those are our children and our elderly.
Right now, manufacturers of the vaccine are trying to keep up with demand. But Donohue is adamant there is not a vaccine shortage.
It always happens. We always tend to run up short because people are getting vaccinated, which is wonderful. And we will get a resupply in.
By late October, supply shouldn't be an issue.
You can still get the flu shot in October, so if it's behind, still go get it.
This year's flu vaccine is the same as last year's. Those who have an egg allergy should not be concerned about an adverse reaction to the vaccine. Also, those over the age of 65 are encouraged to ask their physician for a special vaccine that contains a double dose for added immunity. Recently, confirmed cases of enterovirus D68 in Mobile County have raised concerns. Dr. Donohue wants to be clear, the flu vaccine doesn't prevent D68. However,
the enterovirus is making people more aware that viruses can cause complications. And so people might be more aware this year of getting the flu vaccine to maybe protect from other illnesses.
Now, Pam, what's interesting is doctors will say the same thing. The best way to prevent any type of flu illness, wash your hands. 20 seconds, they say, hot water. Rub it with soap for 20 seconds, and if somebody's coughing, sneezing around you, especially go and wash your hands after that. And for the love of Pete, if you're sick, stay home or go to the doctor.
And you know what? When you come in and out of, like, bathroom doors, put a paper towel around the bathroom door and open it. Yeah, you've just washed your hands. Don't touch it again.
Exactly.
It
undoes everything. Yeah,
absolutely. Yeah. What about this flu season, though? Are they anticipating it to be a bad one, or do we know anything?
Well, Pam, again, since they don't have any confirmed cases right now, that is a good sign. It may be a while before they actually know anything, but some projections are that there's going to be a bad winter, which therein lies the rub that you'll probably maybe get sick during that time. But now, it's still early.
Interesting. Last year, we had a very early flu season. Very quickly, though, no confirmed cases of D68 in Central Alabama right now.
That is correct. Children's of Alabama is conducting tests. We should know later this week.
Keep us posted. Thank you very much.